scale of 1 to 10, what are the chances of you hooking up with a bird this holiday?
1 to 10?
Yeah.
A 0.
Don't be so harsh on yourself. I'm sitting here with Bill Tillman, none other, aka Sonny, aka Mr. Wonderful, aka Muggins, I saw you coming. Bill Tillman, tell me about the golf ball and how you brought it into this country in the 80s.
Well, I was playing golf one day with Doug Sanders in 1976. And he said, you know, you will never beat us until your children start playing golf with the big ball. I said, well, I'm on the English Golf Union and I'm on the championship committee. I will bring it up. And I brought it up and it was turned down. And so in 1980, I decided to start a tournament myself using the big ball for amateurs of 3 handicap and better. Now, the same tournament is scratch and better. So we've come a long way.
That is beautiful. Was that any good? Bit right. On a scale of 1 to 10, how good are you at golf?
How good?
Yeah.
About 3.
3. And talk to me about your son, Adam Tillman.
Well, on a scale of 1 to 10, I would say he was, for an amateur, 9.5.
That's quite good.
He's very good.
He's just sizing up a little there. That's very nice. Oh, Jesus. What's happened?
First tee shot today.
Was that a bad one?
Yeah, for me it was, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Terrible.
Swing was terrible.
Say that again.
Honesty is the best of polishers. It's an old saying, honesty is the best policy. And in the furniture game we say, honesty is the best of polishers.
That was a lovely shot. Well done, Bill. Well done. In your opinion, what is the most important thing in life?
Well, there isn't one important thing. There are two.
Okay.
That's health and love. And without those two, life is miserable.
Game quiz, game line, game breakfast, game app.
Play now.
That's how you play golf. And what did you score in that hole?
Me, I was 5 for 2. I was then, sorry.
Is that good?
It's not bad for me.
I'm here to talk to you about melon. Which is the best melon?
Without doubt, the green honeydew melon that's grown in the province of Elche in Murcia in southern Spain.
And what do you think of orange melon? Speak up a little bit.
With the greatest possible respect, I don't rate them at all.
How bad are they?
Well, they're not in the same class.
Thanks for that, Johnny. A word on the street, according to Sky News, you can sing.
Well, very well indeed.
Give me a couple of lines. A few bars? Do you want an intro? Go for it.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. That's enough for today.
ones I used to know. Where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow.
Not very good, though.
And left me crying after you've gone. There's no denying someday, oh, when you go lonely, your upper heart will ache like mine, and you won't be only after you've gone.
What's your favourite song?
Moonlight Becomes You, probably.
And sing it.
What?
Sing it to me.
He's what? Trying to get me recorded.
Sing it to me.
Moonlight becomes you. It goes with your hair. You suddenly know the right thing. To where moonlight becomes you. I'm thrilled at the sight, and I could be so romantic tonight. We're all dressed up to go dreaming. So don't tell me.
What's he doing?
Oh, what a night to go dreaming. Do you mind if I tag along? When I say I love you, I want you to know it's not just because there's moonlight, although moonlight become you so. Listen, Decca of Brunswick will take that up.
Is that all you have to say?
You'll play it back to me.
This is a gent's robe. Now, we call it a gent's robe because it has, when you open the doors at the top, there are trays for his clothes. The top drawer in this particular article is a secretaire drawer where he can write, and then he has other drawers for clothes below that. The piece on the left is a silver table of the Chippendale period, about 1760. But an exceptional one. It's one of the best I've ever seen. In Cuban mahogany, it's very, very beautiful. On the right here, we have a mahogany bureau of the Chippendale period with OG feet. Now, a bureau like that in the 50s and 60s, one could buy in the trade for 40 or 50 pounds. But in the 80s and 90s, it went to as much as £4,000. And now you could probably buy a bureau like that in a sale, but of course it would need a good deal of restoration probably, and that is expensive. But you could probably buy something like that in a sale for a little under £1,000. So you see, 18th century furniture, normal furniture, is as cheap as it's ever been.
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh, just a sigh. And the fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, time goes by. Moonlight and love songs never out of day. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, a case of do or die. And the world will always welcome lovers as time goes by.